Hello and welcome to Awaken the Truth Within with Zoe Gold. Everything really starts with an idea and with your imagination. And you can use this amazing, magnificent tool given to you for your benefit. It can be very, very useful and very, very effective. Or you can truly use it against yourself. Because you know that everything literally started with an idea. The building that you live in, the office building you work in, your car, all the technology that we have, the cities, everything that you see around you, it started with an idea. It started with somebody's imagination. Now, when you were kids, when you were a child, you used this imagination freely. You were flowing the ideas freely. You could see all the beauty of life right in front of you. What happens later in life? Some people still continue doing that for some reasons, and we're not going to go deeply into that. But many actually shut that gift down. And what you do with your imagination, you often use it against yourself by imagining negative outcomes, by imagining things that you learned throughout your physical path that can go wrong, that happened to other people, that could happen to you. So instead of literally flowing the ideas for wanted and the beauty of life and the magnificence and the splendor, this beauty of who you truly are and where you're going, you're actually using imagination to sabotage yourself and stop yourself. Now, it is also about things, I would say like habits or maybe even exercises and sometimes even maybe even rituals like morning rituals. So what you do in order to begin the day? How do you align yourself? Because the way you start the day will literally define, first of all, the quality of the day for you, because your feelings, your inner state influences the quality of your life. And it will also, that aligned state will also influence everything you do, every conversation, every decision you make during the day, the tone of your conversation and the inner attitude when you think about your plans and goals and things that you need to do. And when you communicate with people, when you negotiate something with people, it will touch everything. It will also influence people you love, people you live with, your family members, your friends. So that's how important it is to literally start your morning, and it doesn't have to take a lot of time. It could be 5 minutes, could be less than that, where you just sit down very quietly somewhere and just relax for a second and really and truly connect with you, with yourself, with the real you, connect with the source, with the creator, God, infinite intelligence. And feel that love. Feel the love towards the Creator. And just feel it. Return to your home. Return to where your soul longs for. Return to what you're actually looking for. And when you flow love, when you flow life, you will recognize it, this feeling. Because love is your essence, is at the basis of you. And the more love and this free flow feeling that you feel, you actually feel throughout the day towards different aspects of your life and things that you do, the more you are in your natural state and the more open you are to this beauty of life and free flow of good things that are coming to you. So when you sit down for 5 minutes and you really, or more, could be 10 minutes, whatever, and just enjoy this moment, this oneness, this I am oneness with everything there is, with the energy that creates the world, and you flow and you feel love to the Creator, you will feel this presence and you will feel the enormous, unbelievable, undescribable, unconditional love of Creator, of infinite intelligence, of the source flowing back to you. And when you literally flow your fill your life, your soul, your emotions, your mindset, everything you do with that love, with that knowing, with that infinite presence almighty, when every problem and issue you think about throughout the day, every phone call and every decision and every idea, it goes from that love, it goes from that state, it goes from that presence, it goes from that. That's first of all what makes the journey the most beautiful, pleasant and delicious you could ever have. And the feeling you get is like you don't really need anything else because you've got it. Because in reality, you've got it. You just exercise your mind in the way that you forget that you do. And then in that moment when it feels like you've got it, you don't really need anything else. That's when other stuff that before you thought you needed, or the stuff that is really the calling of your heart, things that you need for your growth, for the fulfillment of your talents, expansion, it all comes to you. From that standpoint. And literally, it is about faith. And faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Because we always talk about alignment with the good that you desire and feeling from the state of dream fulfilled, feeling of the state of the answered prayer in order to really operate from with these laws of the universe, spiritual universe, law of attraction, its basis, law of vibration, like attracts like, and feeling from this invincible state of who you truly are. And often clients ask me, but really it feels like I'm lying. It feels like I look at these things that I have in my life and how can I feel that it is otherwise. But then I ask them, in the moment when you decided to leave, for some people it applies, the relationship that wasn't working, in the moment when you sailed for a new country, in the moment when you started a business, somehow, some way you shifted your focus, you shifted your beliefs from what was, because you didn't have a business, you were not in a new country, and you were in a relationship that didn't work, towards a better life. The worst thing that will actually work, and you focused on that. Was it a lie? Did you lie to yourself? Were you supposed to stay with that, in that broken relationship with that partner for the rest of your life? Because you would say, this is the reality. This is what I have to do. How can I focus on a better life and a better partner for me? How can I focus on a different country, living in a different country and bringing my family there and building my life there? If I'm living here, how can I be thinking about my business if I have this crappy job or whatever, right? No, somehow, for some reason, your focus shifted on something that in that moment, if you think about it, you could say it was just an idea. It wasn't real, right? Real people want real in order to feel it. They wait for the circumstances to change before they can change the way they feel, but it actually starts from within. You shift how you feel first, and then it shifts other things in your life and changes other things. And what is a belief? Belief is nothing but a faith. And what is a faith? Faith is a belief in things that you cannot see. So if you really come from that state of flowing life, flowing love, from that state when you feel love and flow love and feel out towards the Creator, towards Source, and you feel the presence, this presence and this love, unconditional love of Source to you, and you operate and live from that state, and you give your soul what it longs for, and you remember that faith, that belief is just faith, and faith is actually the belief in things that you cannot see, and you flow your ideas, and you go for it, and you go from it from that standpoint of inner invincibility, which you can only find in that love towards this presence of Almighty, towards the Creator, and this love that flows back to you from the Creator, this unconditional love this presence, then you truly become not just invincible, you become joyous, you become like a kid. It becomes even tastier than the most beautiful day on the summer holiday when you were a child and you were enjoying yourself. Because it's in your essence, and this way you allow yourself to tap into what you've been looking for everywhere. But you forgot the only place where you can actually find it. You can connect with it from within, but it has always been there, always is, and always been, will be there. And you can go there right now. Because it's not a place outside. It is a place within. And you can allow yourself to live it, be it, feel it, know it every day or not. So I hope this was helpful for you. This is Zoe Gold, and I will talk to you in our next episode. Thank you. Bye now.